Hi, church family. It's Sarah Beth Thompson, and I'm here with my lovely husband, Jeff. And it's finally the end of 2020.
Pretty excited about all that. And you know, one of the things that we think about a lot of times at the end of the year is bringing our tithes and our offerings up to date. And Malachi 3 tells us in verse 10, bring the full tithe into the storehouse. And so we're told from God's word that we're supposed to bring our full tithe back to the Lord. We don't want to end the year with any of God's money at our house. And it's also a great opportunity for us to look back in the ways that the Lord has worked this year and to bring him offerings because of his faithfulness to us. And we've seen time and time again where God has met us when we've stepped out in faith in some ways. And we have so many stories, really specific stories, of how God has met us and really done what Malachi 3 says and to pour out blessing on us because of our faithfulness with our finances.
Yeah, I mean, it's an opportunity to trust the Lord more. We always knew that it would be a challenge for me to be able to have children in the natural sort of way. And we jumped through a bunch of hoops to be able to have our first child, Judah. And after that, I was kind of like, I don't think I want to do that again. So we decided to pursue adoption. And we were, you know, it's expensive to adopt a child. And so we were scrimping and saving and gathering our pennies, like literally gathering our pennies. We had a jar, you know, to get ready for our adoption. And it was like after Christmas, we had asked for money for Christmas for adoption. But the end of the year was coming and we knew that this was going to happen. There was going to be this call from the church to give. And we wanted to give above and beyond. And we wanted to show God that we believed in him and what he could do, and to show our trust in him and his faithfulness to us, and to just offer our hearts in thanksgiving. And where your treasure is, there your heart shall be also, right? Yeah. So we took everything, which wasn't much yet, but we took everything we had saved so far and we just gave it to the church. We just were like, this is for you, the Lord. And, you know, time went on and we were still pursuing adoption in the new year, and we got through the whole process. We saved up more money. We made it through the entire process, all the applications and stuff. And I just wasn't feeling well. And I was kind of cranky. Really cranky. And I was like, I think I need to go to the doctor. And then it occurred to me, I was like, maybe I should take a pregnancy test. And this was like beyond the realm of possibility. Like there was no chance I was pregnant. But I was like, you know, I should try. We'll just see. And I mean, over the course of the years of us trying to get pregnant with our first child, I must have taken like 40 pregnancy tests. So I was well versed in how to do this. And I took one and there it was. There were two lines on the little stick. And I was like, holy cow, what in the world? You know, and we were pregnant and we had our son, Elias. And it wasn't like, I don't tell you this to say, like to downplay adoption and its value, because we adopted our third child, Hope, and she is just as much our child as either of our sons who came biologically. But it was a testimony of the faithfulness of God in our lives. And this isn't a common story. Like, this isn't something you hear every day. Like, most people don't magically get pregnant the moment they decide they're going to adopt. It was like, this was beyond the realm of possibility. And God did it. God showed himself faithful in a way that he wanted to in our lives. And it started with us just trusting him with everything. And trusting him to be who he says he is, which is faithful and true. And he does show us an abundance of blessing in response.
Yeah. And it was just such a reminder of this passage for us. That's Malachi 3. You know, he says, bring the full tithe into the storehouse. And then he says, and thereby put me to the test, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the windows of heaven for you and pour down for you a blessing until there's no more need. And so we've just seen this to be a principle. This is the only place in God's word where he says, test me in this. And we have tested the Lord over and over, and every time he has poured out blessing to us. And it's almost never been in the way that we would have expected.
Yeah.
It's almost never been in the way that, you know, sometimes it's not even in the way that we would have asked for. But God has been so faithful to us.
Yeah.
And so as we come to the end of the year, you know, we don't know what you're going to give. That's between you and the Lord. But we know that God loves a cheerful giver. And we know here that God says to test him in that. And so my charge to you would be, test the Lord. When you step out in faith, God will answer that. It is in his word, and I believe this, and we have seen it to be true. So whatever you decide for this year end, I hope that the Lord will continue to bless you and be working in you, and that you will see his faithfulness in a new way in 2021. You are loved.